I love money. Now, before you get all upset and say money is the root of all evil, which is quoted in the Bible, and don't forget the Bible also said women shouldn't speak in the church and slaves should obey their slave master. So I think it's fair to say we have to put everything in context and we have to expand on our thought. When I say I love money, I'm not saying I want to hurt, oppress, or manipulate people to get money. I'm saying I want to work and I do work. I work three jobs. I've always worked my entire life to obtain money the right way. Because the last time I've heard a pastor say money is the root of all evil, 10 minutes later, he's sending a collection plate around and implying that you should give 10% of everything you own to him or to her. So I am saying that I love money and I work for it because I like the freedom that it gives me. I cut my expenses and started living out of my car so I can pile up more money to have more freedom. Because when you live at your means or above your means, you are going to be more subject to be controlled by your job, by society, by your family members, by the relationship you're in. Money, I don't sit there and, say like Scrooge McDuck, like I want to swim around in gold, even though I'm not mad at that. Like I like to swim around in like green digital digits, like, my bank account. But I just like the fact that it allows me to live a more free, creative life and not worrying about what other people think or being controlled by other people. Because when you don't have enough money and you have to worry about that, you are controlled by people. So what I'm here to tell you is that there's nothing wrong with loving money as long as you are not hurting, manipulating, or oppressing people to get it. And if you work in entertainment industry or the like hostess industry, if you're in a restaurant waitress or waiter, you get a tip. So I do DoorDash as my second job. I get tips sometimes. Sometimes I don't. I still give everyone the same service. Sometimes I do YouTube. I get a tip. Sometimes I don't. But I still give the same effort and energy into videos and to replying to comments. So there is nothing wrong. Don't let anyone shame you into loving money as long as you don't put it above certain principles. And godly principles are basically not hurting, manipulating, or oppressing people. That's godly principles. I mean, you can read the whole Bible, which I did, and I understand it in its context. I also understand it was put together by all men, basically under pressure by the government. And so that's a whole other thing. I love God. I love money. I love people, but sometimes I hate people. But you understand what I'm saying? The spirit, the context of this message, as long as you're obtaining money the right way, and there's nothing wrong with getting excited about money. You have to watch yourself. You have to be content because you'll never, in one sense, have enough. But there's nothing also wrong with striving for more. So I'm trying to give you a balance of thought. I'm also trying to say, look, when you're in certain industries, if you're a waiter or a stripper, some of your money is going to be through tips. There's nothing wrong with that. I used to go to strip club. I used to tip girls. All right. So when I used to be overweight ordering dinner every night, I used to tip the delivery person. So, I've tipped people on YouTube. So I'm trying to expand on my life and my thoughts on the subject of I love money. Money emoji. God bless.